things are too strange to be believed. Nothing is too strange to have happened. These words belong to English novelist and poet Thomas Hall. And I also believe that these words are very true this evening. But this saying doesn't mean that it is difficult to believe that this exhibition is taking place in Tallin right now. And I'm very happy that this actually is second coming of EJ to Estonia, to Tallin. The first one happened almost 4 years ago in connection to Her Majesty's state visit to Baltic countries, and it was jointly exhibition with Yuri Alek, who is also among us is lying quiet tonight. It was probably almost 10 years ago when I first made my acquaintance with the marvelous world of EJ paintings. But what struck me most was that after the terrible event of 9/11, I saw the painting of a white angel leading a tiger. And this very frightened, dangerous animal was very tame on this picture and led angel to world. Maybe I have never grown up. Maybe I am an idealist, but I am convinced that the evil will never win. And I guess that this is also the belief which we share with you, which is also very much present on your paintings. Another thing what I like very much speaking about EJ works is that, as we all can see, she's painting on the frames. She's breaking the borders. And for me, who I have forced to experience the totalitarian system for 30 years, it does mean something extraordinary, that you are going out of frames. There are no frames anymore. The colorful life is around us. But let us not be deceived entirely by the bright colors painted by you. There are very many hidden symbols around us. And in particular, I would like to point to this huge, large painting called Fin de siècle, the end of the century. But if we look very closely on it, it could very well and sadly be also the beginning of the century. But this is not a sad picture, although it might frighten at the first glance. Actually, there is deep hope in them. We see two guardians, we see watchdogs, and we see Lady in blue, wearing a gas mask, because there is danger hovering on the horizon. There is panic on the streets. But this lady in blue is Virgin Mary. Virgin Mary, who is holding her protective hand on child Jesus Christ. And this symbol is very important, especially now when we are ending Lent and preparing us for resurrection. Because I believe that we all would like to be better persons than we are today. All is better tomorrow. At least we hope that we can be. And this is thanks you that you have brought this colorful, wonderful world to Tallinn, to Estonia, and let it also be the first signs of true spring. The true spring in surrounding us and also in our hearts. I am very privileged to call you as a friend. I'm very happy that you follow this invitation. I'm very pleased that Richard stepped forward. You are also among us because Richard and PJ, they belong together. And I am very grateful to Vaal, Gallerii. who, without any hesitation, supported the idea to arrange this exhibition, and our hearts and minds are going out to Mr. Jukaste in these difficult times he's facing right now. But well, I'm very happy that this exhibition is taking place, and I wish all possible and impossible success to you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. It is a great honour for me to be here tonight exhibiting in this beautiful, beautiful gallery space. Little did I know when I received an email 10 years ago from someone telling me they came from a little country in the far north, and that he liked the particular painting of the Asian tiger that we'd removed from the website, and could we please put it back on? And he also added that he would like to see an exhibition of my work in his country. And I thought, that's wishful thinking. I had no idea that a few years later I'd get an invitation from the Estonian embassy in London, from the same Margus. But Margus wasn't the junior diplomat that I had supposed him to be. He was His Excellency, the Estonian ambassador. And I have to say that his friendship and presence in our country has so enriched our lives. We've learned so much about Estonia and its history and culture. And his passion to share it has led us to welcome in Cheltenham, the town where we live, the Estonian Philharmonic Choir. A wonderful, wonderful occasion. The year before last, we had the great joy of watching two of your premier ballet dancers, Thomas Edieux and Agnes Oakes, dancing at Shadler's Wells in London. A magical experience that will remain in my mind's eye forever. Margus has been very generous with his time because, you know, I think ambassadors are hugely busy. But he always makes time when he can to attend things. And in 2006, he came to Gloucester City Museum to open an exhibition of my work there in collaboration with the rock musician Robert Fripp, the great guitarist. And as Margus has pointed out, these two paintings belong to Robert and Royal. But it was my privilege a few months prior to that to introduce Margus at the opening of another exhibition I had at Cheltenham Art Gallery Museum to Robert and Royal. So I take a secret joy in knowing that I had introduced them, and knowing that when Robert and Toya came here, that they were enjoying the same relationship that we have with Margus. As you know, this is my second exhibition, and it was a huge privilege for me to exhibit with Yuri Arrow, who, if he was British, we would call our national treasure. He's a great artist, and it was wonderful for me to have that pleasure of showing with him at the Dracon Gallery. At that time, Dr. Margus said, I'd like to see a bigger exhibition of your work. And I thought, oh, he's so sweet, he's such a dreamer. Of course, he's the sort of dreamer who makes dreams become reality. And so that's why I'm here tonight. So I'd like to say a very big thank you to Dr. Margus, to Mr. Jukaste, to all the staff, and particularly to Barbara, who has curated and organized this exhibition, and even came with her boyfriend and Margus to meet us at the airport last night.